Amazon snatches AWS web address.
Microsoft acquires Loeb.
Alibaba's co-founder steps down.
Healthcare organizations select Oracle.
These stories and more are coming up on this week's Lifter Cloud Roundup, September 21st, 2018.
Welcome to another edition of the Lifter Cloud Roundup on lifternews.com. We're your anchor, Shaylee Webb.
And Corey Bowling, here to guide you through some interesting changes in the cloud and how they impacted the Lifter Index.
Just 12 short years after launching AWS, it seems that Amazon has bought the domain aws.com. The update was spotted by the domain name Wire website Whois, who reported that the domain change happened sometime between September 11th and September 12th.
The domain was first registered in 1995 and was owned by AWS Convergence Technologies, Inc. Although the companies share similar names, this one is part of Earth Networks that runs weatherbug.com.
Amazon has most likely had the web address in their sites for quite some time, but they are currently still hosting their public cloud on aws.amazon.com. The company recently started using the .brand name .aws in marketing, so who knows how long it will take for us to see the new domain go into effect.
Microsoft has announced that it has acquired Loeb, a startup that allows you to build machine learning models with the help of a drag-and-drop interface. The company plans to use these abilities to build upon its own efforts of making AI models easier to build. Loeb was co-founded by Mike Mattis, who previously worked on the iPhone and iPad, as well as Facebook's Paper and Instant Articles products.
It's no secret that machine learning talent is hard to come by. Microsoft also recently bought Bonsai.ai, a deep reinforcement learning platform, and Semantic Machines, a conversational AI platform. Loeb's approach complements Microsoft's existing Azure ML Studio platform, which also offers a drag-and-drop interface for building machine learning models. However, Azure's has a more utilitarian design.
Microsoft's EVP and CTO Kevin Scott wrote in an announcement, quote, "In many ways, though, we're only just beginning to tap into the full potential AI can provide."
Chris Tung, the chief marketing officer at Alibaba Group, announced that Jack Ma, the company's co-founder and chairman, is stepping down. Tung stated Alibaba will last, quote, "with or without Jack Ma, because Ma was good at creating a strong corporate culture that inspires people within the organization to pursue their passions in line with the wider vision."
The current Alibaba chief executive Daniel Zhang will replace Ma. However, Ma will complete his term on Alibaba's board of directors following the company's annual general meeting. This period is to ensure a smooth transition within the Chinese technology giant.
To get a deeper insight into Alibaba Cloud and how they stack up against other major cloud providers, check out our Alibaba Cloud report available right now on lifternews.com.
A number of healthcare organizations are choosing Oracle Cloud as their preferred provider of applications. Delta Dental in California and its enterprise affiliates, Mount Sinai Health Systems and University of Wisconsin Health, are all making the switch. The healthcare providers will use Oracle applications to enhance business visibility, increase agility, reduce costs, and future-proof their organizations.
It is more difficult than ever for healthcare organizations to deliver optimum patient care due to increased competition, costs, and regulatory complexity. Many are turning to cloud to address these challenges. Moving to Oracle Cloud application enables them to rapidly leverage new artificial intelligence, blockchain, and Internet of Things capabilities as they are added.
Sarah Chavaria, the Chief Human Resources Officer for Delta Dental, said, quote, "As we create an employee experience that empowers our people to take action when and where they need, Oracle's HCM Cloud platform provides our human resources team with the necessary benefits, compensation, and talent management data to be more responsive to our employees' needs."
Oracle's Open World event is coming up in October. Lifter's principal analyst Paul Teich will be on site at the event. We're looking forward to hearing more about Oracle's HCM Cloud platform and keeping you all updated. That's a wrap on this week's Lifter Cloud Roundup. Has your business made major strides using cloud? We want to hear from you. Email us at ideas@lifternews.com.
And we'd like to wish a happy birthday to one of our producers and writers here at Lifter News, Kylie Perry.
From all of us here at Lifter News, happy birthday, Kylie.